our topic is about variables in research. Okay. Variable is the root word vary, or simply can change. These variables are among the fundamental concepts of research, alongside with measurements, validity, reliability, cause and effect, and theory. Okay, we have types of variables. Okay, number one, continuous variables. A variable that can take infinite number on the value that can occur within the population. Examples: age, height, and temperature. Why age? Because the age of individual is continuous from zero age up to the end. Why height? Because the height of individual is continuous until becomes old. Of course, also temperature is continuous. Okay, under continuous, we have interval variables. It is a measurement where the difference between two values does have meaning. Example, the interval data of temperature and the person's net worth. Okay, letter B, we have the ratio variables. It have values that lie along an evenly dispersed range of numbers when there is absolute zero. It possesses the properties of interval variable and has a clear definition of zero. Example, height, weight, and distance. Why height? Because height begins at zero. Also, weight begins at zero, and also the distance begins at zero. Okay, so we have number two, the discrete discrete variables, or this is countable variable. Okay, so this is also known as categorical or classificatory variable. This is any variable that has limited number of distinct values. Examples like sex, blood type, and number of children. Why blood type? Why sex? Sex because we have only two types of sex, the male and female. Why blood type? Blood type because a blood type is countable, and that is type A, B, C, AB, E plus, B plus, E minus, B minus, and number of children in the family. Okay, discrete variable may also categorize into letter A, nominal variable. It represent categories that cannot be ordered in any particular way. Examples like eye color, business type, religion, biological sex, and political affiliation. Letter B, the ordinal variable. Ordinal variable, it represent categories that can be ordered from greatest to smallest. Examples like educational level, income brackets. Okay, why we include educational level? It is because we can create order in education. Let us say the high school graduate is 1, college graduate is 2, masteral graduate is 3, doctoral graduate is 4, And also, we can create ordered in brackets. Let us say 10,000 to 15,000, 1, 16,000 to 20,000, 2, 21,000 to 25,000, 3, 26,000 to 30,000 is 4. Okay? So, we have also the kinds of variables. Okay, we have the independent variable. Dependent variable, those that probably cause, influence, or affect outcomes. They are invariably called treatment, manipulated, antecedent, or predictor variables. So we have an example, a study on the relationship of study habits and academic performance of ICNHS, senior high school students. So in this example, the study habit is our independent variable. Okay, so we have also a dependent variable. Those that depend on the independent variables, they are the outcomes or result of the influence of the independent variable. So example, a study on the relationship of study habits and academic performance of ICNHS senior high school students, and this time academic performance is our dependent variable. So we have also the intervening or meddling variables that stand between the independent and dependent variables and show the effects of the independent variables on the dependent variables. Okay. The example of the intervening variables in the study of the relationship of the study habit and academic performance. The possible variables intervene between the study habit and academic performance are watching TV, playing gadgets, or more. So number 4, we have the control variables. Control variables is a special type of independent variables that are measured in the study because they potentially influence the dependent variable. Maybe demographic or personal variables that need to be controlled so that the true influence of the independent variable on the dependent variable can be determined. The example of control variable are the family background of the respondents, educational attainment of the respondents, social status of the respondents, and more. Okay, number 5, the confounding variables. Variables that are not actually measured or observed in a study. They exist, but their influence cannot be directly identified in the study. Researchers comment on the influence of confounding variables after the study has been completed. Okay, so most of the researcher can detect confounding variables after the study is done. Ito ay pagkukulang sa isang study na pwede itong isali ang pagkukulang na ito doon sa recommendation so that if the study is replicated, pwede nang i-observe ang variables na yan. Thank you.